Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot and welcome back to our Paleo Zoo build for Jurassic World Evolution 2. In the last video we added a slightly bonkers shark tunnel kind of thing. We've done our viewing display, we've done our lid and we've done our Tyrannosaurus over there back when things were a bit more normal. But today we're going to finish off the aquatic section. We're going to do a underwater monorail tour kind of thing, or at least that's the idea. I've tried to record this video about 4 times now because none of my ideas bloody work, but I think I finally cracked how to do this. I had a vague recollection of doing this in the past, but I think I'm wrong. So I've had to kind of invent how you do this again. We are going to leave this section over here. If I curl this path around, I'm going to leave this open. There's a little bit of room here. So if we get more ideas for the aquatic section, we can of course expand it later on. I don't have any great ideas right now, so we're going to move on after this video. Now, the problem with the monorail. So if I grab my monorail here, and again, I thought this was like a super common thing that loads of people had done, but I tell you what, it's not that easy to do. So I thought, I had 2 different plans. The first was to raise the ground up, put the lagoon on top. Obviously, you'd raise it higher than that, and then you'd put the monorail through the lagoon. But, of course, that doesn't work, because when the monorail finds the raised ground, it, it itself jumps up. It doesn't stay low. And I want the monorail to go through the water. The idea is to have this underwater submarine-esque tour. The other idea I had was, of course, to place these down and then lift up, and the monorail will go through. And that actually works fine. The problem with this is you then can't connect on, as you can see. So the only way I can think of to actually pull this off is a little bit weird, but that's what we're going to do. So what we're going to do, we're going to build like a tour. So it's all going to be one in terms of like length. And it's kind of curve around a little bit. And I think that's probably big enough, right? That's quite a big lagoon. Now, of course, if I put the monorail over this, that's not going to work, right? It's just going to sink. Well, it's not going to sink. It's just going to go over the top. And that could make a pretty cool exhibit, you know, taking your monorail over the top of the lagoon. But it's not really what I'm looking for. As far as I can tell, the only way, and I think I want one here if I can. Oh. That might be cooler. Let's do that. The only way to make this work is this. We grab the monorail, and you see, because I've connected it to the path, it stays connected. That's just the magic of cryogenic, basically. We're going to grab our monorail, we're going to drag it over here, and we're going to sink it under the water, like so. And I believe that is way too low for a start. Oh, no. Okay, there we go. Back up a little bit. Maybe about there. I'm looking for it to be about... Yeah, that's going to... I mean, I think this is going to look really cool. So you can see how the path is actually still connected. So I think what we can do is maybe put like a little viewing area or something over there with the seats that descend down. And it could... We can kind of build something that might look like a tunnel from the path to the underwater monorail. And now, if I edit the track... Might have to move. This might be a... Oh, wait. Why are you raising up? What are you doing? Don't do that. No! This was my only plan. This is all I had. Okay, I've tried for a really, really long time, and it is going to work, but it's not going to be as perfect as I had in mind. But it's gonna be... It's gonna be cool. I have faith in the coolness. So, what we have to do... And it really is the only way I can think of to make this work. I tried multiple stations and then having the thing between them on like a long track, but the track keeps bouncing up above the water. It's been a whole thing. We just need to attach this nice and quickly again. Lovely stuff. Grab that, spin it around. Nope. Grab that, spin it around. One day I'll remember these buttons off by heart. And then sink it down. And we're looking for probably about there. Let's have a little peek. Whoa, no, I did it again. Okay, so I want these to all be... We're going to have to use the stations. It's the only way to do it. So I kind of want to get a look at these little... What if they stick just above the water? That's a really good way for me to know where exactly to put them. So what we have to do, really, to make this work, is to use multiple stations. Now, it's a little bit of a shame. However, it's not that big a deal just because... I said so. No, because... I know what I mean. Because Oh, when you actually go down there, when you're on the track itself, you know, when you're using the tour, you never see inside the station anyway with the monorail. You always see above the ground anyway, so it should still look okay. I hope. Okay, so that's the idea. We're going to link all these together. And then hopefully that'll work. I cannot for the life of me think of a better way to do this. So if anyone's got any alternate ideas, feel free to let me know. But this is for me as good as it gets. And it doesn't mean it's going to be very stop-stop. But just think of it as like observation points, right? Now the hope is that these are small enough gaps that when we grab this, and as you can see if we sink it down, there we go, to about that. Same over here. Sink it down. If I then grab this. Oh, hello. So when it's already underwater. Now the problem is, of course, this only goes in a straight line. Okay, now I think we may have just found our alternate plan. We're going to do the same again. We're going to grab our monorail. I'm going to attach the path first. I don't know if that's actually important, but it feels like it probably is. Whoopsie-daisy. I'm going to grab that. We're going to hit Y to rotate it to get it nice and level. And we're going to sink it down so the little bits just about pop up like so. And then we do something else. We're going to go along. No, wait, no. We're attaching this separately, right? I'm just trying to replicate it exactly. Oh. Right, one sec. It's going to attach that path. Right. My brain is kind of going blah, blah, blah. Do all these things. It'll work better. We're going to delete these trees. My brain often goes blah, 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 to be fair. It's nothing new. I'm just going to stick a building in. Not that. Let's just stick an attraction in there. It's only temporary. It's just so I've got something to latch this path onto. So that will be connected. We're going to grab that. And then that's connected like that, which is what I wanted. I think this may have worked without the building, but just in case. Now, I swear I tried this before and it didn't work. Why did it not? Oh, right. No, so I think... Right, yes. So what we do... I'm going to show you what I mean. So if I put this here... I'm going to tell you what I mean because I'm scared that I'll break something. If I put this monorail here, sink it down and attach it... You know, tell you what, I'll just show you. This is important. I'm doing science. Right, so we've done that. Grab it again. We're going to hold B. We're going to sink it down. And now if I attach this, if it's like it was last time, it'll start low underwater, but then it'll go up. And then it'll sink back down. Right? Which is cool in a very different way, but not what I'm looking for. So what I think we specifically have to do is grab it, move it super close, so that the track is only underwater. Come on. Oh, there we go. And then we move it back. And oh, baby. Now we're cooking. Actually, I can put that like there. Maybe move this one a bit to the right. I kind of want this one to be like... Ah, oh, screw it. It's fine. Okay. Hey, figured it out. Very cool. And you just head forth into the darkness. There, yeah, that's pretty sweet. And that's your way out. All right, cool. Cool. It's not perfectly what I had in mind. I'm not going to pretend otherwise, but it has worked. And I think it looks pretty awesome, actually. So pretty happy that this has worked out at all. Let's get some trees. Make it all pretty like. Right, so let me just... Yeah, oh, that's going to be very cool. Okay, I think this is actually the only viable way to make this happen. And you could make it longer, of course, or do funky shapes. But all your funky shapes would have to have a monorail, like, because it's only going to work in a roughly straight line in any direction, but it'll always be a straight line. You would have to, for every curve, would have to be a new station, right? Which is not necessarily a bad thing, and maybe something we'll consider, but at least it bloody works. Right, so... So, let's get some critters in here. Let's get our lagoon hatchery. And let's get some shark feeders. I've got to remember that with this mod currently, And this mod being the Megalodon, that's what we're about to use. There it is. Oh, I'm so excited. With this mod currently, if you feed it fish, the world will die. So we're going to try to avoid that. Let's pick some cool colours. Let's go for that one. We're going to have quite a few of these because it's quite a big exhibit, even if it doesn't necessarily look it. Let's have 5 Megalodons. Let's just go crazy. My wild card, what can I say? And we're gonna do custom colours for each one. We're going to pick them. So I've got like a black one with white stripes. Let's go for our white one with black stripes. Let's go for what I assume is approximately the default one. I think the default is Death Valley Rana. I'm not sure. Let's go for that. And let's go for a blue-whitish one. Try to get our sort of great white vibe in there, which I know is such a cliche, but I don't care. Let's go those two. And let's try to find something cool for the last one. What is the funkiest base colour? It's a purple one. I think green might look really cool, actually. Mangrove or Sala del Huesco? Sala del Huesco with some Paleo Phylax over the top. That should be a bunch of very cool Megalodons. I think feeding's turned off because, rather unsurprisingly, a lot of these creatures were beginning to die. So anyways, let's check out this. This is, of course, the LA Studios Megalodon. I will link it down below. It looks so good. That is going to look so good on the monorail. And that's why we need multiple of them. I just want to watch all these. I'm very excited about this. Ooh. I've just thought about one more thing I maybe want to do for the lagoons. I kind of want to do... Well, maybe if we're going to do like an aviary section next. Because that's something else we can screw around with. You know, try weird things with an aviary section. What if the midpoint between, you know, in the way that we had the Tylosaurus, Chronosaurus, I should say, breaching the gap between the outback section and the aquatic section. What if for Chronosaurus? Did I say Chronosaurus? Yeah. What if for the next section we had a lagoon slash aviary, which of course is something quite easy to do. That might be an interesting idea. More Megalodons. I love my Lodons to be nice and mega. Used to have a small load on. Wait, no, that's a weird sentence. Let's move on from that sentence. Okay, looking very cool. Which one's this one again? Can't remember. I'm hoping they spread out. They don't need to eat, so... Very cool. Oh, I like this one. I thought they all had the same exit animation, so it's nice to see it mixed up a little bit. Spooky. Very spooky. Looking cool. Oh, man. It's like an episode of the Meg. Well, an episode of the Meg. It's like the Meg. One more. I mean, that's pretty awesome. Isn't that terrifying? It actually looks so good. Right, what I'm going to do is grab a couple of them. I'm hoping that if I just move them to different parts of the exhibit, they'll kind of just stay there for some reason. Right, so we also need some other things. I don't have any of the other mods installed right now. I should have kept the little ichthyosaur. I've kind of included everything else already. How big is Leoplerodon? It can't be that big, surely. If it's breeding 5 of them. I think Leoplerodons is like mid-size, right? We're going to have a batch of Leoplerodons. Just 5 of them. Go random. And then I know we've already had ichthyosaurs, but I think we need some ichthyosaurs as well. You need something smaller swimming around, creating havoc, right? So we're going to get a bunch of ichthys. And by a bunch, I do mean a bunch. I'm thinking 24 of them. Because it's quite a big exhibit. And what we might do is install sweeteners. I can't remember. The teeny little, a little adorable ichthyosaur from the last video. What was it called? Ah! Worth noting, by the way, that Leoplerodon still has like the coolest exit animation in the entire game. This was not the cool version of it, but it's still pretty cool. The Leoplerodon really grew on me. Must be said. So, is there a way we can make that look more realistic? Because you know I'm all about the realism. What we could do, actually, if I grab another one of these, grab that, move it there, sink it down, about there. And then we're going to rotate, so it's like that. I want to connect those two sides together. So it kind of looks like you go down into there, and that takes you into the tunnel, and that takes you into the monorail. It's not perfect, but at least it makes... There's like some... there's a nod to realism. It may not be realistic, but there's a nod towards it. Right, I want to decorate this more later, but there is a certain decoration I want to use right now. So shout out. So first of all, shout out to LA Studios for the Megalodon, which is fantastic. And to Cryodenic, as always, for all the mods that let me do all the crazy stuff we do. And shout out to Scaryface, who has made some fantastic... If you haven't seen my... I think it was the Megalodon video. No, it wasn't the Megalodon video. It was the Shantungosaurus video. Scaryface has come out with a pack of like 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 26, 26 statues of various creatures in the game, and they are amazing. So we can take our little ichthyosaur and we can do like a little display kind of thing right outside the front door. Love that. We can take our mosasaur, maybe make it like a centerpiece for the area. It is floating, but we can make it. Oh, actually, the fact it's floating is really helpful right now. So what we can do, we can have that hang over the front like that. And then I think this was the idea. Scary did reply to me on the comment section that you then use these as a kind of supporting structure. Is that the idea? I think that's the idea. Now obviously we have a slight problem here. Yeah. Is this legit? Let me just think about this for a bit. Give me a minute. I'll think of a way to legitimize all of this. I'm going to attach a light to it. That's what I'm going to do. And then you can walk through there. I think that's really cool. The world is your oyster, ladies and gentlemen. Just do crazy things. Have some fun with it. No reason to limit yourselves, really. Do we have any more wet things? Let me have a little look. I think that might be the only two aquatic... Oh, no, we've got a plesiosaurus. I know there's no plesiosaurus in there, but... Come on, it's awesome. Like, how could I resist? Yep. And we need a lagoon sign, of course. I like that. I'm not going to do all this now. I just wanted to showcase some of this, because I really, really like this stuff. I think it looks really good. We might even move the mosasaurus, because the mosasaurus is, I believe, in here. But I really like the idea of having like a central plaza area. You could have like a fountain underneath your mosasaurus statue, yada yada. You could just make some really, really cool looking stuff, I think. I'm a big fan, in case you can't tell. And we're going to use these throughout the entire park. This is now going to be a consistent thing, which does make me want to use the dinosaurs from that selection more, but hey-ho. Okay, whatever. Like I said, we're going to save the decoration, but let's give it a little ride. Oh, wait, that's the wrong thing. this one, and then show view. I don't know what is going on. Did I click the wrong mono? This looks amazing! Doesn't that look really cool? That looks incredible. That's proper atmospheric. I think I clicked the wrong monorail. Right, now I'm just confused. Oh, it's because we were... Oh, man. Man, that looks so good. Wait, what? Okay, that's... we have a slight problem at the far end. Let me just shuffle that back a little bit like so. That should be fine now. It's a little quick. It's a lot quicker than I thought it was, which makes me kind of want to extend the whole thing. Or we could put a station in the middle. I think that's a good idea. Let's do that. This might require a bit of work, but I think it's gonna work. I think we need like a resting point, like halfway through. Right, I need to think. Okay, I'm gonna make this work. Don't worry about it. Don't you worry your pretty little heads. That's why it's kind of like we're cooking, right? You gotta keep testing what you're doing. So is that gonna be close enough? Yeah, sweet. Okay, I thought that was gonna be annoying. They are both close enough, and that is still functioning? Question mark. Yeah, looks like it. Sweet. Okay, so that should give you now like a resting point halfway through. Okay, so this is the start, and because the other monorail is kind of laid over the top of it, it looks a bit funky. So we're going that way, and this is the other monorail. This is like the entrance monorail, the tunnel that you walk through to get onto the monorail. Over the top. I think that looks right. I don't know what it is about that view, but it makes me really happy. It looks like an underwater research lab or something. And you move forward. You see your megalodons. You get to here, and we should stop. Any second now. There we go. So you get to sit here. Yeah, this was a really good idea. You get to sit here and you get to observe for a little bit. And hear some cool noises as well. Yeah! I wish I could turn my head all the way around. I don't know why this is a limited view. That always annoyed me. But, yeah, very cool. This means I don't need to extend the lagoon. Because you've got a really nice observation point now. Oh, it looks so good. Oh, wait, stop, thank you. One thing I like about that as well is this is not too crazy, right? This is within the realms of possibility. You know, this isn't something absolutely insane like everything else we built. So it's a nice way to move on. Yeah, okay, well, we're going to end it there. I'm pretty happy with everything in that, pretty happy with what we built today. It took a little finagling, took a little bit of working out, but we made it and I think it looks really cool. So, unless anyone has any really fun, stupid ideas for me to try with the lagoons, then I am open to fun, stupid ideas. Anytime you want to throw them at me, please do let me know. Yeah, really had a good time. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Shout out to Kyodenic and the Open Naja team and to Scary's Faces, Scary Face Statues. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Oh, and to LA Studios. Okay, bye. Reaching out.